Now you listen to me real good. I've told you once, I said it 1,000 times. You get out of those pagan, satanic, religious, Christian churches. Christians do not follow the commandments of the Bible. Christians do what they want to do. They make up their own laws, their own rules, and their own regulations. Come out of her, my people, and come out from among them. And it's real simple and easy to ascertain who are these people you need to come out from. Easy. Number one, if they keep Sunday, that's an automatic sign that you need to not have any fellowship with these commandment-breaking, wicked deceivers and seducers and bewitchers of the truth. Simple.
Shalom, 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 shalom is right, yeah. Greetings. Each and every last one of you, sweet, precious, strong, victorious, and mighty, overcoming name, our soon coming King, Jesus the Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glad to be here this evening. Of course, we have saints coming in. Many saints have already sent their feast offering in. We got the saints from New York. Brought Auxilio. Brother Mike. Sister Diana. Sister Alasia. Then we have the mothers. Mother Bullock. Mother Newkirk. Mother Zaza. Then we have Sister Brittany. Hallelujah. Lord to the King. That are here. And then we have Brother John, Lord to the King, Sister Renee, and you know, all the people here for the feast. Who? I ain't got to Georgia yet. I just started. Jesus. Alright. Then we have Georgia here tomorrow today. Elder Rufus, Sister Jennifer, Moo Moo, Sister Sandra. It's a beautiful thing seeing the saints of the Most High God. We're getting ready for the Feast of Pentecost. Glory to the King. I love Israel. I love them with all my heart. Truly do. I appreciate the sacrifice of them coming. You know, of course, it's always a joy to see them. It really, truly is. Then we have Feast of Pentecost coming, but Elder Rufus is going to be preaching tomorrow. Lord to the King. I'll be preaching Pentecost, and I'll be on the road to Canada the next day. Y'all pray for me, for my journey, please, Israel. And then myself and Sister Carol will be heading on to Canada in a few days. Teacher Shane will be doing scripture study. Elder Donnie gonna be delivering Shabbat message. Glory to the King. We are in some very trying times. The great falling away is on. Don't y'all listen to me. It's on. People are falling away from the faith, falling away from the truth, falling away from the Most High in favor of this world. You make sure that the enemy is not enticing you too much, too greatly, that he is trying to tempt you to come right out the paper. Hallelujah. It's a battle. It's a war. It's a fight. Fight of our life. You only got one of them. I thought about a few people died just this past week. Big name people. Muhammad Ali, Kimbo Slice. Every time I hear about someone dying, it just lets me know how frail this body is. One of them 74 years old, the other one 42 years old. And you know what? No man knows the day nor the hour. The day nor the hour. We're watching the decline like never before. I do appreciate all the attentiveness to the messages. If I heard it once, I heard it 100 times of how everybody is truly appreciating the messages of marriage, biblical marriage, because everybody is coming in a way that people didn't think. What is that, hon? They're coming in a way they didn't really think it was going to happen. And we're learning about our covenant with the Most High Yah and how much He has sacrificed, how much He has given us, and for that we're grateful and we're thankful. So we're looking to have a wonderful time in the Most High Yah tomorrow. But what I need from Israel, I know that we're already students of the Word. And the power operates greatly among us. Ah, Israel, we need for you to really try to make sure that you dedicate some time each day to spend with the Most High. It's getting bad. We got the Pentecost coming up, and you know, it's a reminder of the Ruach, which the majority of people in the world today don't want. Don't know why, but they don't want it. My. I do solicit your prayers for this upcoming travel, because we usually fly to Canada and deal with customs and stuff like that, but I see that the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals that's out on the West Coast, that they're after your guns. I hope everybody's being wise about guns carrying. I really, truly do. The reason why they want the guns is because they want a docile, compliant people. There is much to be desired. I'm going to go ahead, because I don't want to spend too much time tonight just rambling on about stuff that you hear me talk about on YouTube. But I can tell you the road is getting very narrow and the way is very straight. And as a people, man, I tell you, what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? It's unbelievable. It really is. It's totally unbelievable. I wish people were serious about the soul's salvation. The Most High Yah didn't fill us with the Holy Spirit so that we can, I don't know what, exist? I don't believe that for 1 minute. I believe He gave us the Holy Spirit so we can have power. Glory to the King. So, what I'm going to do is go ahead and go to the phone calls. Now, let's limit it to one question. Don't get on here and say, Pastor Dow, I have one question in five parts. One question, okay? Jesus. Mercy. And don't try to give us a dissertation or a thesis. please just get straight to your question or whatever it is, because there's a lot of people. Y'all see how long the guest calling or the caller queue is? It's a long time. Thank you. So the guest caller number is 310-92-4226. 310-92-4226. Guest calling number is 310-982-4226. You hit number one, you'll be in the caller queue. I'm going to actually go up here real quick. And I'm going to check the board again, because, man, there wasn't too many people in here. I guess everybody's busy, man. They should be getting ready for the Sabbath, but I know the Sabbath's not in yet. But anyway, we'll listen to Rule of the Universe. Give you time to get in the caller queue. I'll be right back.
So I'm a man of God. And he says, tomorrow I want you in Africa, guess where I'm going to be at? If I want you in Germany tomorrow, guess where I'm going to be at? That's why I'm not reverend, I'm not pope, I'm not bishop, I'm not deacon, I'm not elder. That's why my name is Pastor Charles Dowell. There's a difference. You hear me, brother? There's a difference. And this is wrong with the church today. The reason why it's so powerless. Now see, the thing that God is going to deviate from his plan and from his book the way he has always done it. He ain't going to do it. Man is going to deviate, but God is not going to deviate. Jesus said, you come follow me. I know what. Everybody wonder what I'm doing too. I'm also getting that spirit too. Dealing with some curses. We're going to get a hold of that thing in a minute. Hey, can you bring her right here, brother? Put her right here so me and that spirit can have some altercations here. So anyway, I was surprised that the young man didn't get mad at me. And I told him, I said, brother, I'm sorry, brother. I knew when God had so-called, because we learned that terminology, called me to preach. I said, I knew what happened. The day he did that, bro, I was ready to leave. See how that spirit took look. See that spirit, dude? That's that spirit. Now, you remember how I told you that everybody here know that ain't her. We know that, don't you? You understand that, right? So you're at peace with that, right? You're good, brother. That's good. Amen. Said she couldn't listen to my message because that spirit kept, you know what I mean, on cut of food. Boy, I hate them things, bro. I hate them things, bro. Look at them. I hate them. I hate them. Look at them. See it, Pastor?
Man, they must think a lot about you then.
We're going to find out which one it is in a minute. Put some sisters and stuff on it.
Somebody's burning.
By the way, what's your name, Spirit? Hey, you hear me talking to you. What's your name? Yeah, you got a name. What is it?
Ayn.
You Ayn what?
Ayn.
You're the ruler of the universe. Which one? You rule everything. Well, it don't look like you're doing such a good job of ruling today. And I tell you what, ruler of the universe, I bind you right now in the name of Jesus. And I command you to go down until I get finished. And when I get finished, we'll deal with you. And I command you to stop your harassing, tempting, driving, and tormenting right now. You hear me? Go down right now. All right, Sister Linda, you all right?
Well, that's enough of that. Don't y'all keep Pastor Corey. Pastor Tatum, Pastor Fox, all the pastors in lifted up, really truly do during this feast day, feast season. Hallelujah. All right, let's go to the first one. I see there, New Jersey, call number 609-609, Brother Felix. This is Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight Bit 2 Radio broadcast. How can I help you, Brother Felix?
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor. How you doing, Pastor?
Shabbat Shalom, my brother. Shabbat Shalom. I'm doing well. Doing well.
Hallelujah. Glory to the King. Good to see you. I was just calling, Pastor, to just wish you bad shalom to you and the family, and to let you know that we're still here doing what we're supposed to do. I'm glad for the affiliate and for the mic with our sisters were able to make it down there safely. Hallelujah. And we're doing well, Pastor. The Father is doing well. He's doing good. He's taking care of us. And we are definitely blessed to, again, have the opportunity to be where we are, listening to you and the Straightway Ministry. That's a fantastic thing, what the Father is doing and how he's opening doors and how he is, you know, I see the growth in the ministry. I see the blessings in the ministry, and I am very thankful to you, and I want to encourage you, Pastor, to, again, don't stop preaching.
Don't stop preaching.
Don't stop preaching, Pastor.
I'm not going to keep on. I'm going to keep on laying it to the line, Brother Felix.
Glory to the King. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Pastor. It's been encouraging. Rebecca, thank you so much, sir, for your labor. I mean, I know how hard you labor. We appreciate every one of you, the sisters, even the sisters in the kitchen, Sister Kyle, everybody. We just appreciate you. Rufus, thank you so much, all Straightway. Thank you. Bless you, Pastor. Bless everyone.
Hallelujah. Bless you, Hallelujah. Brother. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom, Pastor.
Lord to the King. And also, Brother Jermaine, who's on, you know, the head of the Straightway Tech team, he's here along with Mother Beasley. Now, when Mother Beasley come, she's the oldest person in the ministry. She actually stays in the house with myself and Sister Carol. Hallelujah. And it's always good to see them. Now, Mother Beasley, 92 years old, she can make it to the feast. They're not making it. Glory to the kingdom. I don't think we're going to see too many people like Mother Beasley, man. She runs around like, man, she's 40 years old. Mother Bullock is another one. Mother Bullock is 62 years old. And you'll never know when you go. You'll look up one minute, she may be here, may be there, may be over there, over here, over there. She is always rolling. Of course, we try to help it out too. Because we got to get Mother Bullock up to Canada to visit Brother Steve and Sister Winter, so we'll set that up for our mother. Hallelujah. That was faithful Brother Felix. Go to Brother Junior, call number 929-929. Look like y'all getting that greenhouse up, Brother Junior. That's a good job. It's Pastor Dow. You on Straightway 2 radio broadcast. How can I help you there, Brother Junior?
Yes, sir. I'm learning how to do the greenhouse. Learning how to do it. Learning.
Beautiful.
Just turn my mouth and I'm saying listen to a instructor, whatever. Yeah, but I like the thing you did about perception. I remember that?
Yeah.
That gray shirt on?
Yeah.
I like that. I love that video, Pastor. I love that video. You know what I'm saying? You teaching this year, you know what I'm saying? It's naturally preaching and teaching you're doing, you know what I'm saying? Y'all know your offenses, you know what I'm saying? Y'all know your offenses? Y'all know the law? Don't get offended. You know what I'm saying? Don't get offended. Y'all know your offense.
Yeah.
If you know what I'm saying? That's why people, you know, far away. You know what I'm saying? I feel it, man. I love this challenge. I love the challenge. Your challenge you're putting out in the preaching and teachings and the videos. I love the challenges, Pastor. I love being challenged. To put myself in the mirror, so, you know, I can sound good even me, to sound good even other people. You know what I'm saying?
And
people ain't serious, you're gonna get gone. The bones don't even bone. The bones gonna be exposed and gone, you know what I'm saying? I don't wanna be a bum in y'all's eyes. I don't wanna be a bum. I wanna be holy. You know what I'm saying? I don't.
Well, hallelujah.
I mean, hold on.
Keep striving in here,
Excuse me, Pastor?
Keep striving in here at the straight gate.
Okay. That's what I'm doing, man. You know, I'm saying, like the teachings, you've been doing, like, still getting fit, and the next thing, you don't see no more, you know what I'm saying? Like, you start acting, that's changing, you know what I'm saying? You know, it's, the fall ain't doing no more. They read their mind, so they going next, they next. You could tell, you know what I'm saying? How they act, how they talk, you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
You could tell. I understand, Pastor. I understand where you're coming from, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you can tell.
I understand that.
You can tell when a spirit enters into someone.
Absolutely, Pastor, absolutely. Like, one, the thing, like you say in that video, they call you a friend, call you brothers, and so when you preach on the law, they don't agree with it. Now they're enemy, now they hate you now, you know what I'm saying? Because they hate the Father, they don't hate you, they hate the Father.
Yeah.
Like, why? You gotta watch your words. What you say? What I say, Pastor? You my pastor, Pastor. You my pastor. I'm your brother. I'm your son. You know what I'm saying? I'm your son, you're my father, you know what I'm saying? I mean too, Pastor, so I go all the way to the kingdom, you know what I'm saying? With patience, you know what I'm saying?
Hallelujah.
I'm going to win. Father, I know Father hear me, but, you know, I'm making it best I can, you know what I'm saying? So keep preaching, keep challenging me, Pastor, so I'll get challenged more and more, so I'll get ready for what's going to come up in the future, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, time is short, you know what I'm saying? See how fast this week went, Pastor? Went so fast. Just like that. Yep. Yup, the king's coming, man. Time is short, Pastor. Time is short, but people don't see that. Hey, but we see it. So, you take care, Pastor. You stay encouraged. I'm praying for all the Pastor, all the elders, and the whole ministry, Pastor. You take care. Shabbat shalom, Pastor.
Bless you, Brother Junior. Shabbat shalom. I'm with Brother Junior.
Yeah.
These weeks, they are flying by. And I mean, you ain't going to tell me that time hasn't sped up. Because, man, it seems like we're getting less done and we work here straightway than what we ever have done. I mean, it's flying by. You know, I received a couple reports this week about people who used to live at the community going out there spitting in saints' ears. What's amazing to me is the stuff that you people listen to. I mean, you've been listening to me all these years. You should know me by now. Utterly amazing. Utterly amazing. I'll just leave it at that. It ain't worth even talking about. Hey, let's go to Texas. Call number 210-210. It's Pastor Dow in Texas. Straight with two radio broadcasts. I can help you.
Shalom, I'm Shepherd from Santa Maria, Miguel.
Hey, bless you, my brother. Kind of coming in, kind of a little garbled. Not broken and distorted, but a little bit of garbled.
Yes, sir. I'm actually on the road with the Saints. I got Sister Crystal and the children with me. We're headed off to Dallas to be with Brother Josh and the other Saints.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Tell Sister Krista and the children, Pastor said hi.
Pastor said hello. Mm-hmm. It says Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
That's all, Pastor. I just wanted to call in. Bless you, sir. Love you.
My brother, you be safe on that road, okay?
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Shabbat Shalom. Glory to the King. Let's go to Brother Dominic. 718-718, New York. New York, big city of perversion. Everything in New York is nothing but demonic darkness. Brother Dominic, how you doing?
Oh, Pastor, come on.
Well, brother, I'm in the midst of talking about demons, man, and it just kind of got mixed up, if you know what I mean.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor. How you doing?
All right, my brother. Doing well. Bless you.
Bless you. I didn't have much to say. I was actually just calling in just to say Shabbat shalom to you, Shabbat shalom to Israel, and Shabbat shalom to my brothers that are down there, Arcelio, Alasia, Brother Mike, Diana. Miss you guys.
They here.
That's all I got, Pastor.
They yep, here, yep, and yep, they yep. are happy.
I know they're going to turn it up for us all. But yeah, Pastor, I was just calling in to say Shabbat Shalom, and I'm excited, very, very, very excited to hear Elder Rufus Shabbat.
All right, my brother, bless you. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Same New York. Let's go, Brother Steve. Old faithful Brother Steve up in New York, 347-347. It's Pastor Dow, you're serving to learn your broadcast. I can hear it, Brother Steve.
Ah, Shabbat Shalom, my shepherd Shabbat. So you got, oh, Pastor, you got to have mercy on my brother. My goodness.
Yeah.
Yes, sir, Pastor. Very similarly, man, I have to touch and agree with Brother Junior. My goodness, I felt like it was just the other week we were down there for Passover. And it's already Pentecost. It's amazing how time just flies by.
Yeah, 50 days.
Man. Yeah. Wow. It's amazing. I just want to, you know, say Shabbat Shalom. You know, definitely shout out to my brothers and sisters. I'm so thankful. I was praying for them on the road down there, and I'm so thankful that they reached their safely. I know you guys are going to take great care of them. I'm definitely going to miss them this weekend. You know, just want to say Shabbat Shalom. I love you all, Shaylee, and I know you will take amazing care of my beautiful brothers and sisters over there. Please watch out for them and take amazing care, as I know you will do.
You know they're in good care.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Pastor, I love you all. I love you, my Pastor. You have been teaching me so much about marriage the last 2 weeks, especially in preparation for the times to come for me. And it's been very helpful. And I've been eating plentiful this last week, almost having to separate time just to catch up.
Hey, these are some very inspirational, very educational, very scholarly, very historical messages that the Most High Yah is allowing us to hear.
Yes, sir, Pastor. Actually, that video, Marriage 101, oh, man, Pastor, you hit some chords in that video.
Yeah.
That whole segment was such education. I thank you so much for that.
Well, you are welcome.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All right, Pastor. That's all I got. Bless you. Shabbat shalom. And I love you all so very much. Bless you.
Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom, my brother. Boy, I tell you, Sister Kathy, you can hear me. And if that little one is up, I want y'all to see somebody who I think has even got Pastor Dow eyes beat. And she's a newborn. Man, she's a beautiful baby. She looks just like CeeLo. But I'm telling you, I believe this little girl got my eyes beaten. I got Popeyes. They used to call me Popeye the Sailor Man when I was younger. Here she is. Look how beautiful she is, though. Come on. Come on, Sister Cat. Look at here. Look at this. I want y'all to look. Look. Look at Dahlia. Dahlia, look at the people. Look at the people saying hi. Dahlia, look, look, look. Oh. We're going to hear a howl. Tribulation. You finished? You going back to mama. See you later. See y'all. Well, you can't see them big eyes like that, can you? J. She's a beautiful little girl. Mama says she's tired. You know, we got to see everything. All right, where we at? Let's go to Texas. Call number 210-210 is Pastor Dial. You're on the Strictly Tube Radio broadcast. I can help you. Got a lot of babies around here. Texas, 210, you there? Okay. Texas gone. Let's go to Maryland. Call number 443-443, Brother Brad. It's Pastor Dial. You're on the Strictly Tube Radio broadcast. I can help you there, Brother Brad. Brother Brad, 443.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor.
Woo, Shabbat shalom, brother. I was just getting ready to let you go.
Now, check it out. Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom, Pastor.
Shabbat shalom.
We just wanted to check in with you, Pastor. We just wanted to check in with you. We love you. We need you. We send up prayers and blessings for you, Pastor, and keep going.
Hallelujah.
Please, we need you.
Hallelujah, my brother. We'll keep going. Father's will, we will definitely keep going.
We need real men in this world, and you're one of them. You're part of Yah. We know it. The Straightway Maryland knows it, and we're following you, Pastor.
Well, hallelujah. I hear Brother James back there and Brother Mike. Y'all holding it down, huh?
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, sir, Pastor. Yes, sir. We will do so.
All right, Brother Brad.
Shabbat shalom to you.
Shabbat
shalom, Pastor.
Shabbat shalom, Maryland. You know, I went up there with Brother Scott. Man, that was the lowest. I ain't never seen it that low. I wonder if it's because, you know, the daylight hours extending. Sabbath hadn't got in yet. But, man, Bro Scott, can you go up there and check and see where is that now? I want to kind of get a gauge on how many people is there listening. Hey, you think Dahlia's fine now? We'll let her go back to her mom because I don't want her getting to crying again. These little babies are ruling the world nowadays. Hallelujah. Where we at? Let's go to Brother Chili in Florida. No? Okay, 44. All right, Brother Scott. Nah, we'll go to New York first, then we'll go to Brother Chili. New York been waiting longer. New York, call number 646-646, Pastor Dial, you're on the Strictly Tube Radio broadcast. How can I help you there in New York?
Hello?
Hell is low.
Hello, Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
It's my first time calling in. This is Brother Chad.
Brother Chad?
Yes, yes, from New York. You know, I've been recently watching the vids more often. I was actually baptized with GOCC, but I moved over to Straight Wave for some major differences that they practice over there.
Wow. Hey, welcome aboard. You know, we have a lot of people that are up in the New York area, and it's really not a lot like people think it is, but we have a lot of people that recently come over from GOCC. They become part of our home fellowships and stuff like that, and I tell you what, my brother, would you like to get in contact with some of our fired-up Israelite saints up there in New York?
I actually have. I called in maybe like a week or two ago, actually, and I'm fellowshipping with our brother Felix out in Jersey. So I did that this past weekend, and we had an amazing time, and I'm looking forward to our future endeavors.
Glory to the King. You hooked up one of the best Israelites out there on the East Coast.
Hallelujah. Yes. I actually had a bunch of questions, but you know, since we narrowed it down to one, I'm just gonna as far as observing the Sabbath, What are some of the things we are allowed and not allowed to do? I know it's kind of a loaded question, but, you know, schoolwork, reading books, you know, traveling during the Sabbath to, like, family's home and observe there and that kind of stuff.
Well, the Sabbath is pretty simple. It really is. What you want to do, my brothers, you want to try to spend that day with the family of Yah. You want to spend it around Israelites who fear your Elohim like you do, who fear the Most High Yah like you do. And you want to rest. Because remember, this rest is hard for some people to enter into. Hebrews speak to us about that, but we can enter into it. You want to rest. You don't want to buy and sell. And you want to travel. If you can travel without buying and selling, if you can just fill up your car before the Sabbath and then travel to your destination, and as long as you can get there, and without getting a tank of gas, and sometimes you do have to buy. It's not really as strict and buy as like people think that it is. There's a liberty in the Sabbath for us to be able to keep it. But the ideal is to stay around and hang around the saints of the Most High Yah to where you can grow. But the ideal of the Sabbath is rest, 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 and rest.
Absolutely.
Rest in Him, my brother. And sure, you can read books or something like that as long as you're resting and stuff. But do what you can to keep your mind stayed on Him, though. That's what the Shabbat is all about.
Right, right. Absolutely. Well, Pastor, it's definitely great to call in, and I'm looking forward to, you know, making this a weekly thing and, you know, following the Most High. So
let me ask you a question.
You know, I'm glad to, yes.
I know, you know, we, be it Kansas City, Texas, Georgia, New York, New Jersey or whatever, GOCC must be, I guess, pretty big or whatever it is, but there seems to be a lot of people at GOCC that actually listens to Straightway. So what is it about Straightway that ends up drawing people over from GOCC? Do you know?
To be honest, the way I came over to Straightway is my uncle actually found you guys first. And I actually look up to my uncle, Brother Dionys. You might know him. You might, you know, you might not. I'm not sure. But he pointed out some stuff. I actually myself wasn't following to the best of my ability. It's just been more recent with a lot of events, more the Flat Earth event and everything like that, that I took the opportunity to the mass deliverance that you just recently had. I took the opportunity to partake in that and cut everything out of my life cold turkey that has nothing to do with Most High, whether it was born out, whatever the case is. I just completely cut everything cold turkey. So that's how I ended up with you guys, and I'm glad. You know, and you know, again, my uncle has been doing this way longer than me, so I do look up to him, and I do trust his knowledge in the whole thing. So that's how I ended up with you guys, and I'm you know, glad I'm here. And just from what I've been watching, there's just with GOCC wide, there's a little division on, you know, who gets to go into heaven and that, those kind of things, and the division of us and other people that follow that are not Israelites and whatnot.
Well, I do appreciate hearing me. Yes, I'm familiar with your uncle. He supports us, prayed for us, been and seen some of the saints, and I'm glad that you fellowship with Brother Felix. He's a real good Israelite. Hallelujah. Thank you for calling.
I'm glad to, and I'm 100% glad I had to turn a new leaf, because I don't know what it was before that I was taking it as a joke, but whatever it was, it put it to light, and hallelujah to the Most High that I'm here.
Well, glory to the King. Glory to the King, my brother. Keep listening. Keep watching, okay?
Yes, definitely. Shabbat shalom, and speak to you soon.
Shabbat shalom. Let's go to Florida. 310, Brother Chili is Pastor Dowie on Streaming 2 Radio broadcast. How can I help you there, Brother Chili?
How we doing, Pastor Dow? and straightway and Israelites here in the blood.
Bless the Lord. How we doing? Hi, y'all. Howdy, favor. Doing well. You know, it's a joy for me to see my family. I'm so honored that they actually travel great distances to come to see me and the saints of the Most High Yah here, and it's just a blessing. It really truly is. I truly am humbled every time I see them, because it's a great honor to see that they follow me as I follow Christ. And so, you know, I have a lot of souls that watch me and listen to me, and I do make sure I live holy according to what the book says, and I make sure that I try to be the best example of a man that I can be. Other than that, I'm encouraged, my brother.
Yeah, that's one of the main reasons I listen to you, because you sound like as far as I can determine, and I have pretty good discernment. You're a man of integrity. You mean what you say what you mean. So if I could follow anybody as the way they follow Christ, would be a man that means what he says and says what he means.
Hallelujah.
There's no sidestepping with you. It is what it is.
Hallelujah. It's the truth, and, man. I will always support the truth.
Yeah, that's what honestly brings me comfort. Is it the fact that if I'm right or wrong, or even if God forbid you're right or wrong, the truth will always come out. So that's a beautiful thing. I just got a praise report. I was raised in a household that I was raised the oldest, and that's why I had older siblings, because of my parents' sins in the past and stuff like that. Well, I have an older brother that he's a police officer right now in New York. He's 36 years old, 37. And he knows the Torah is the truth, but he just doesn't know how to follow it, because he doesn't have a religious background at all. He just knows that when he reads the Bible, it makes absolute truth to him, and there's no confusion in it. So today, or actually during this week, we were having a beautiful conversation on hearing the voice of God and how to hear the voice of God and how to determine to hear the voice of God. And I basically tell her, if it doesn't align with Scripture, it cannot be with God. But the Spirit of where it be. So I'm just excited that my brother, my oldest brother, it's kind of funny because I have the oldest brother mindset, and he's actually the other brother, so he has an older brother mindset, but we were raised in basically in two separate families. So it's a very weird relationship, but I just praise God for that. I was dealing with a past second. That's the praise report right there. I got a question. How would you address this situation? This female pastor said that God created man and woman, right? But he created woman to be the helpmate for the man. So that obviously says that the man needs help. They said that's why God created women pastors. And how would you address that statement?
First of all, number one, you're not going to stop this woman for being... She may be a woman Christian pastor, but she definitely is not an Israelite pastor, because there are no women in Israel that are pastors. There's only one title that I'm aware of that in the old covenant that the women have, and that was prophetess. A woman has never been called to be a pastor. And she's never been, and if it's obvious, think about it. When you look at the priesthood, who just happened to be the judges, the elders, and the ministers, were any of them men? No. And remember, Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. When Jesus picked his 12 apostles, 12 disciples, were any of them men? No. No. He would not send a woman out two by two every kind to do this work. It's a man's job. And when you talk about apostles, prophets, pastors, evangelists, pastors, and teachers, these are calling that the Most High Yah put on men. And men do. Now, women do have a great calling in being mothers and examples. And the older women, to teach them how to guide the house, they got a tall order when you're dealing with women. But it's just a shame, you know, she's been bit by the false doctrine, the false teaching. She's not going to hear the verse, suffer not a woman to preach, nor to teach, nor to usurp authority over man. Well, she's commanded being in silence or in obedience to say of the law. And they're just not going to hear that. They're not going to hear it. And if I was you, I wouldn't even spend too much time speaking with her.
Yeah, I'm not planning to. The fly-by-night conversation that occurred. I didn't entertain it too much. I just basically told her, you're not supposed to exert authority over a man, so how are you going to teach? How are you going to put a man in his place?
Right.
You can't. That's part of preaching. That's part of pastoring. You got to set the people in order. Sometimes you got to whip them with the rod and stuff. There's no way possible a sheep could do that.
Not a man.
That was my... Yeah, exactly. Not a man. That was my rebuttal. But I like a whole lot better yours. But again, the Figueroa family here in St. Pete, Florida, we're doing good. Praising the Most High, enjoying the Sabbath. Getting ready to watch a video tomorrow for the Sabbath service. And just again, I just love that I actually fellowship even at a distance, which is a little disheartening, but one day we will meet.
Sure.
Just super excited that I could literally put my guard down and know that the scripture is the thermostat of truth and the straight way home.
Glory to the King, it is.
But Shabbat Shalom and thank you for your time.
Shabbat Shalom, my brother. Be encouraged. Let's go to Korea. Call number 931-931. Brother Reynolds. This is Pastor Dow. You're going to serve you the radio broadcast. Shabbat. How can I help, Brother Reynolds?
Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom, Pastor. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, my brother. How is it over there in the land?
Oh, it is wonderful. But I wanted to say we're getting shorter than a roach in the corner.
Woo!
I'm getting ready to do the duffel bag track.
Oh, man, you mean to tell me you so short that if you jump off a dime, you'll break your leg?
Yes, sir.
we coming up with the military terms, huh? And phrases.
Yes, sir.
Oh, it's all right, my brother. It's all right. Looking forward to seeing you.
Yes, sir. We should be there soon. And I just want to say... I pray that the Most High continue to bless you and Sister Carol and the Straightway family worldwide.
Hallelujah.
And we should see you soon, brother.
Well, hallelujah. Keep Shabbat praying, shalom. Folks. Shabbat shalom, my brother. Good to hear from Brother Reynolds over in Korea. Hallelujah. They're like 11 hours ahead of us. All right. Let's go to Florida, Brother Marcise. Brother Marcise is Pastor Dow. You're on the Tribute Youth Radio broadcast. How can I help you, Brother Marcy?
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Yeah, I've been a narcissist with an end, though. With an end. But I just wanted to just call in and just, like, I was fellowshipping with Brother Felix. As you know, I called you last week, and, you know, I'm originally from Florida, but, you know, the Most High got me up here to... New York, and I was able to have the privilege to fellowship with Brother Felix and the brothers, you know. Last Shabbat, I had a deliverance after. Oh my goodness. It was crazy. And it's just like, I'm still amazed at the power in Christ Jesus that I've never witnessed in these Christian churches.
Woo!
It's just Wow.
Amazing, isn't it?
And it's amazing. It's like manna from heaven. Like, and the brothers delivered me. And I can't really tell the story because I don't want to waste too much time. I know there's a lot of brothers that want to, get talk to you. But, oh my goodness. Praise y'all. Praise.
I tell you what, the book, the Bible is alive, isn't it?
it's ridiculous. And one of the things that I experienced in that in that was just the presence of Yah throughout the whole experience. And I just wanted to just say, you know, also greet Straightway. I call this ministry my home now.
Glory.
And I just wanted you to know that first. You know, and I want to ask you a question too.
What is the difference between mass deliverance and deliverance?
Well, mass deliverance is when you have a whole bunch of people together, and the majority of them are getting delivered at one time. All of, you know, it's just taking place at once. Deliverance, it's the same thing. It still accomplishes the same thing. Demons are being cast out.
Mm-hmm.
But even though, you know, we're doing mass deliverance and stuff, you know, the real power lies with the people that have to get down and deal with those spirits that are manifesting. Them saints are really working hard for the king.
Hallelujah. Yeah, all right, thank you. But I just wanted to say that, you know, I feel the covering. It's like I can feel spirit covering, ministry covering me from, it's like you can feel the covering over you. You know, and I'm like, how did this happen? Like, what was I missing out the whole time? Like, I've been missing out. And it's just, you know, and like I always say, man, Brother D. Jeremy is the one that actually reached out to. Actually, it happened like this. The Father came to me in a vision and told me to reach out to Brother D. Jeremy. And I reached out to Brother D. Jeremy, and he showed me you. And at first, it was a little shaky. We was clashing swords and whatnot. But, you know, the Father continued to just be patient with me and to allow me to because he knew this was the ministry. And before I done watched a lot of ministries, GOCC, I didn't want to spend time with them because they just a lot of nonsense they got going on. And other ministries, we talk about a man is the Holy Spirit and all type of stuff, and it just didn't make sense. But out of all the ministries that I watched, you know, in the sermon, I knew this was the truth. That I knew this straightway was a balanced ministry. And I saw out straightway to try to see where's error. And I find that. Like you live everything according to scripture. And it's just, man, it's amazing, man. And I feel like I found my home. I know I found my home. You know, and a spiritual father that's definitely a spiritual shepherd, a pastor that's there to guide me. And I've just been, you know, soaking myself in your word, wake up to it, go to sleep to it, in the word. And just, man, it's just a blessing. I just wanted to say Shabbat Shalom to all the saints. I want to appreciate Brother Dominique for coming way out there to come pick me up. You know, and just Brother Felix for inviting the saints to his home. And just, this is love, man. This is love. Like,
yeah, it is. Well, welcome aboard, my brother.
Yeah, so, you know, you're going to be hearing from me every week. I'm going to let you know that I'm coming with all type of questions and everything, but I'm just hungry to learn and to just help build Israel. And I realize it's not just a ministry, it's about restoring Israel back. That's what the Father's trying to do. And I'm going to be a part of it, and I'm going to make sure that we the Father.
All right, my brother.
Hallelujah. Shabbat Shalom. Everybody out there, thanks.
All right, Shabbat Shalom, Brother Marcin. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
What I have in my hand, in my arms, and these little children and babies are wrestlers with Pastor Dow, I have little Nathaniel Bell, Nehemiah Bell. Look at him. Don't he look just like Zeppelin? Yep. He was born here on the land the straightway. Isn't he a beautiful little baby? Look at him. He's probably reaching for his mama. He's reaching for me. He's out there hanging 10 right now. And he is every bit of maybe a little bit over 40-something days year old. 40-something days years old. Jesus, help me, Father. But he's a healthy little boy. He really is. Now, our women, our sisters, they, I don't know what y'all do out in the world, but we found it best to follow the Torah. And our little boys, they're in the house for a particular period of time. And our little girls, the boys over a month, a little over a month, the girls over 2 months. And he's sleeping. Nehemiah. Nehemiah, he ain't waking up. He keep grabbing for me. Anyway, I'm going to get the sisters to come and get him because he ain't having it. He going to stay asleep. Bless you. See you later, Israel. Another Israelite born on the land of straightway. Glory to the King. That's Brother Doug Bells, Sister Ashley's little boy. Of course, Sister Ashley, she's glad to be out of the house. I promise you. And, you know, we just found it better to obey the Torah and let our women stay in the house during that monthly purification without having babies. And every single one of them will attest that it makes the babies healthier, they're stronger, more resilient, or they don't get as sick like the children do in the world. The Most High just know what he's doing. We just obey the law. I mean, so you don't have to be under the law, but we under a law. We under obedience. Let's go to Canada to Brother Steve and our Brother Canada. Brother Canada. Jesus. I must be tired. That's what it is. I don't know. But anyway, Brother Steve in Canada is calling number 705 Pastor Dow, you know, Sherby Truth Radio broadcast. How can I help you, my brother?
Hi, Shalom, our pastor.
Shabbat Shalom.
Did you hear that, Pastor?
Man, did I ever hear that. That's a lot of children.
Well, we have the London tribe out here, Brother Dwayne and Sister Jane.
Oh, I remember him.
Beautiful. Yes, sir. We got our Brother Paul over here. He's cleaning up the barbecue now. He's bringing in the lamb that he's had tonight.
Woo! Shabbat Shalom, man.
We're having a feast.
I can tell. Y'all going to have a good feast. Bless y'all.
We're going to have an even bigger feast when you're up.
Oh, hallelujah. It's going to be, we got about, 3 days, if that much? We'll be on the road to be up there.
Yes, sir. And like you said, time is flying by, and he said that's going to be flying by for the saints, so it's for our benefit.
It's utterly amazing how fast time is flying by.
Yes, sir. We got Brother Dwayne here. Just hold on 1 second. Shabbat Shalom, Pastor.
Hey, bless you, Brother Dwayne. How you doing, my brother? Long time no here.
Yes, sir. We've been blessed, Pastor, and doing wonderful, sir. Doing wonderful. We continue with. Yeah, we've been very blessed, sir. We had another baby daughter 2.5 months ago at home, and very, very blessed, sir. Very blessed.
Glory to the King.
Yeah, glory. And we brought all the children up to visit with all 6 of them.
Woo!
Brother Steve.
That's a lot of children.
Yeah, it's been pretty. Should have seen the look on his face when we pulled in.
Well, children bring life to a home.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do. And, you know, we're very happy that we get to share this with Brother Steve and Sister Wenda and Brother Paul as well. Definitely.
Hallelujah. Bless Brother Ugly for me.
Hallelujah, Pastor.
Hey,
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor.
Can y'all tell me what the weather? Can you tell me what the weather is like up there right now at night? Because down here it's pretty cool for this time of year, which it shouldn't be. So, what is the weather like up there?
Well, right now it's probably about 20 degrees Celsius, and it's clear. I believe.
So it's about 50-something degrees, 57 degrees at night, as far as Fahrenheit?
Yes. Well, it's been going down to 10 or 15 degrees Celsius anyway. But, yeah, okay. It's 66 American degrees right now. It's 66 American degrees right now.
All right.
So, you know, oh yeah, it's pretty nice in the evenings. There's not very many bugs around either, so.
That's
beautiful. It's beautiful. It's nice.
All right, my brother.
Oh, we have Brother Paul here.
Yeah, we have Brother Paul. 1 moment. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, sir. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor. How are you?
Ah, good for hearing your voice, Brother Paul. Doing well, my brother. Doing well. Looking forward to seeing you.
Yes, sir. I can't wait. Another week. Hopefully, y'all will give you a safe journey and no problems at the border. It's such a blessing here to have all the saints and all the children. I don't know if you remember little Jesse, Brother Dwayne's baby boy that you were boxing with last year, but he wants a rematch. He's bigger this year.
Yeah, tell him I'll give him a rematch when I get there.
All right, we're placing our bets now. All right, Pastor, lots of love. May all of Israel have a beautiful Shavuot. Here's Brother Steve again. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom, my brother. Shabbat shalom.
Bless you, brother. Bless you, Pastor. Bless you, family. I just want to let you know that it's between 73 and 77 degrees throughout the whole week when you're here, so it'll be very comfortable. It's comfortable for us. I hope it's comfortable for you.
Well, hallelujah. Hallelujah. That sounds like air conditioning to me.
Oh, there you go. Perfect.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor. Love you.
Bless you, Sister Wenda. Love you.
Hey, Sister Jane here. Sorry.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor.
Bless you, Sister. You doing all right after having that baby?
I'm great.
All right. Glory to the King.
Glory to the King. Thank you, Pastor. We'll see you in a few days.
It'll
be faster than you think.
Y'all make sure y'all keep me lifted up.
Oh, you're lifted up every day here, Pastor. Bless you. Thank you, Israel.
Bless you. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom, everybody.
Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom.
Beautiful.
Hallelujah. That's the northern tribes of Israel. Glory to the King. Where we at? Let's go to Texas. Call number 713-713 is Pastor Dowell in the Shrivey 2 radio broadcast. How can I help you?
Hey, Shabbat shalom, Pastor. It's Brother Mitchell. How you doing, Steve?
Bless you, Brother Mitchell. Shabbat shalom. Doing all right, son. How can I help you?
Hallelujah. Oh, nothing much. I just wanted to call in and say shalom to the fam. Say shalom to Straightway. Shabbat shalom. And you've actually been talking a lot, I noticed. If not every week, probably, I don't know, every 3 weeks or so. And if it's not in the message, you kind of mention it. But you talk about the garments a lot. Zephaniah 1:8.
Yes.
And about 2 weeks ago. And I thought about when you and Brother Scott had went and what I was going to do. And so what I did was I put on my garment and I went downtown. I went and stood in that courtroom and I just feel like.
Bro, Mitch, you broke up on me. I need to hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, go ahead.
Can you hear me now? Okay. Yeah, I was just saying that when I went to this jury duty, I had my garments on.
Yes.
And I just want to, you know, according to our culture, you know what I mean? And I tell you, like what I was saying was, I got even doors open for me when I went.
You what?
And also, I had doors open for me. Like, men, women.
Oh yeah,
you there? Can you hear me?
Yeah, people just honoring you by opening up the door for you.
Yes, sir. Yeah, they were opening up the doors for me, and it was kind of strange, you know what I mean? Because you know, we're our guards from time to time, me and the brothers when we go out. But you know, I just said to myself, maybe I'll get treated a little bit different if I go in the courtroom like that, because you know I wasn't going to swear in, and so I went in there and they had everybody stand up, so I stood up and. You know, they wanted us to start speaking. I just stood there. And, Pastor, I tell you, I felt like just eyes on me, just piercing through me, almost. And I just stood there. I just stood there, stood my ground, but people respected me, though. They I don't know if they thought I was a Muslim or what, but I didn't say nothing. And they just looked at me, and I looked at them, and that was it. And then I had to go through, like, this questionnaire deal. Where they have to figure out if they want you on the panel or not, and they got rid of me quick. I got released probably about like 10:30, so they sent me home. And I was done. I was like, hallelujah, and I got up out of there. But, yeah. I thought I'd share it with you because I just remember you and Brother Scott having a go, and I've been and I kept thinking about Zephaniah 1:8. So I said, where am I going, man? Like, you just know where you're going. I said, yep. Hey, I don't know, you know, when the day gonna come whenever, you know, you don't comply to their laws and they gonna wanna throw you in jail. So I said to myself, I said, you know, a judge could do whatever he want because he throw you in contempt. You know, he can do whatever he want with you. You know what I mean? So I said to myself, well, I ain't told Eric, and I just walked out the house and said, man, I don't know if I'm going to get arrested there or not because I'm going to go all out. Because in my mind, I'm saying to myself, well, Pastor and Brother Scott, they was in a small town, you know what I mean, county. But out here, it's in the city, so I really didn't know how it was going to be, but it really wasn't that bad, though. So, but I was prepared, though, in my mind.
Glory to the King.
But, hallelujah. Yeah, but other than that, we're going to head up there in the morning to Brother Josh's house. The other brother already went ahead of us, so, but, you know, me and Dad got the babies, and we're going to have some of the sisters follow us up there, so we're going to have a good old time. We're going to do the same thing we did last year. We're going to have brothers in tents outside and sisters in the house at night. That's how we're going to do it. So we look forward to this weekend, look forward to the word being brought forth, and one question, do you know what time you're going to do Pentecost service?
Yeah, 11 a.m.
Okay, I don't know if I missed the video or anything. I've been, I catch up when I get home, but the last one I caught was the one you did on the guns. So, but hallelujah. So, but bless you, Pastor. Bless all the straightway. Shabbat shalom. And get a word tomorrow, y'all willing.
All right, my brother. Bless y'all. Shabbat shalom. Wearing his garments. That's all right. Let's go to New York to Brother Jason. Call number 347-347. It's Pastor Dowell. You're on the
Street
with You, the radio broadcast. How can
that
be, Brother Jason?
Shabbat shalom, my Pastor Dow. How are you, sir?
Blessed are the Most High, y'all highly favored. Bless you, my brother.
Oh, it's such a blessing to hear your voice. I wanted to call in last week, but these heathens had me working 20 hours. Oh, I'm so happy to call you in, call it in. Just wanted to thank you, lift you up in prayer. And just your wisdom, Pastor, with these latest videos. I mean, man, going into the law, going into fornication, you know, just talking about this wretched country, these people, man, they, mercy, mercy, mercy. I don't understand, Pastor, how they keep letting these doggone courts make up laws and nobody saying anything about anything.
Yeah,
it just don't
either.
Make any kind of sense.
I don't understand how that the courts can make law from the bench. It just don't make sense. What in the world we got politicians for that's called lawmakers? Whatever.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Pastor. But, you know, just bless you, Pastor. I love you, man. I love Straightway. Just bless all the brothers and sisters in Straightway abroad and down in the land, the brothers down in the land and sisters down in the land. You know, you going into the law has just really built me up. Since I came back in the video, I mean, the attack has came full blown.
Lord.
Yes, but I'm so happy. I'm so blessed to have had to celebrate actually my first Passover, real Passover, and now celebrating my first real Pentecost with real Israelites, brothers and sisters that seeking the faith. I mean, it's just a blessing.
Hallelujah.
Full blessing. So I just thank you, Pastor. I thank you, and I lift you up in prayer. You know, just keep doing what you're doing. But even in the law, going into the law, I had a quick question about the law. I was reading Exodus 34, actually, and I was going into the body and blood when we took it down on Passover, and I just want to know from you first. I just want to know, is this where the body and blood came from? Because we don't eat drink the wine with the unleavened bread. If I could just read the scripture really quick.
Go ahead.
So yeah, it was 34 and 25, Pastor. And it says,
Thou shalt not offer the blood of my sacrifice with leaven, neither shall the sacrifice of the feast of the Passover be left unto the morning. And I was just wondering, is that where the body and blood came from? Because I know everything's from the Old Testament, so, because I know that we eat the unleavened bread, and the Christ said, this is my body and this is my blood, you know, and I was just like putting those two together, but I wanted to ask you, is that correct? I don't know.
That's symbolic. Yes, it is. It's symbolic.
Symbolic. Okay.
Because remember, in the covenant, things are allegories. You understand what I mean? And they speak in order to, they speak from a shadow to go to the concrete. And to try to get us to understand exactly what's going on. But I think you're spot on.
Yes, sir. You know, and that's just reading that. Just thanking you for your wisdom with the law. I mean, nobody has ever touched on fornication like this. Nobody has ever touched on marriage, religion, nothing, man.
They scared.
I mean, we buffoons out here. We don't know nothing. I tell you, man. So I just thank you and bless you, and you know. When you really think about it, when you teach the truth of marriage and you know, fornication and things like that, when you look at this wretched country, you see just how foul and wicked and defiled they really are. Oh,
what you
man,
say?
These
what
people
you say?
Got it coming. Yes, sir.
Mother yes, Bullock sir. Told me that when she was a little girl growing up, and of course, Mother Newkirk is here too, her twin. She told me that in the black community that things were very strict. That if you went to school, are you ready for this, Brother Jason? Are you ready for this?
Uh-oh.
I'll tell you what.
Yes, sir.
I won't do it justice. Mother Bullock, come on back here and tell everybody what you told me about segregation and how things changed. And when you're looking at Mother Bullock, you're looking at Mother Newkirk, you're looking at Mother Newkirk, you're looking at Mother Bullock, you ain't going to be able to tell them apart.
Yes, sir.
The only way you're going to tell them apart is if they're wearing different glasses. Let me let Mother Bullock explain it to you, man. Listen to this. Segregation,
yes, sir.
Brother Jason.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, Mother.
Yes, sir.
Bless you.
Bless you, Mother.
When I was going to school, when growing up, there was no pants. Or if you wore makeup to school, you were sent at home. We had a high respect for the teachers, the principals. The teachers had permission to tear our butts up in class. Most of the bullies that went to school, they end up dropping out of school because they could not control the school, so they just stopped coming to school. We never saw anyone hug or kiss, anything like that at school until we integrated with the Europeans. And it was just even in our classrooms, we were more smarter, brighter, and everything, because we didn't deal with a lot of things. They didn't let a lot of things go on. It was very strict. If you got a spanking at school, when you got home, you got another one, because you did not disrespect any teacher or elderly person. That didn't happen. Not at all.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-mm. So we end up being taught how to be disrespectful when we started going to, when we got integrated, and we would see how the white kids would talk to the teachers and other stuff would happen, and we just got all messed up down through the line, down through time. But at the beginning, it was not so.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, here's Pastor.
Oh, mercy. Oh, bless you, Mother. Thank you.
Bless you.
Oh.
Now, we talking about a little while ago. We talking about a little while ago.
Yes, sir.
And see, what we doing is good when you get eyewitness accounts from people, if you understand what I mean.
Yes, sir.
And you know, yes, now sir. the black community itself, we so illiterate, we so stupid, we so prideful, we so arrogant. We're just, you know, we're really a sick, sad case as people. We really, yes, truly, sir, are. We really there's a bad sickness that runs through us. It is.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's called curses.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. It's very sad. You know, I'm glad you speak out on these things about this country. Yeah, it's a sad situation with our people. So we have to just, like you say, be about our Father's business and staying strong and encouraging the word. And I'm just so very thankful. I'm so very, very, very thankful that the Father had mercy enough on me to lead me to you and the brothers and sisters here straightway. I mean, what a family, what an education, what a love, what an understanding, what a truth, what a life. Hallelujah, 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 brother. Pastor.
All right, bless you, my brother.
Yes, sir. And Shabbat Shalom, and we'll see you at Tabernacles, and I know you're coming up, so I can't wait to see you.
Yeah, I'll be in New York in July. Shabbat Shalom.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Shabbat Shalom.
Let's go to Ohio, Brother Mike in Ohio, call number 614-614. Brother Mike, Pastor Dow, Straightway Truth, how you doing, my brother?
Hallelujah. Oh, Pastor, Yah is a good Yah. Yes, he is.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Mighty, 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 mighty good God.
Oh, Pastor, I got two grandchildren, both boys, 3 and 1.5. And they running around the house, thanks to you putting up the praise and worship on your page. And we're able to listen to the songs that was recorded live in Hopkinsville. 2 grandchildren running around the house singing, Mighty, 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 good, y'all. You all the students. Pastor, I called to just share with you, Pastor. My house is in order. Everyone in this house, my sons, their wives, are in their role. And I want to thank the Most High, first of all. I want to thank the Sisters Broadcast. I want to thank Mother Bulla. It is a true blessing, my son's wife, and the blessing that she has turned out to be, the daughter of Zion that she is. It is truly a blessing and strengthening my house. I want to thank you for your preaching and teaching. I want to thank Elder Becker for the Brothers Broadcast, Teacher Shane for scripture study and Shabbat service preaching. And the Brothers Broadcast, Teacher Shane, and Elder Donnie, First Day Broadcast, Elder Austin for the YouTube videos, the Sabbath preaching, Elder Rufus for First Day Broadcast when he used to cover that. And for Sabbath preaching, because they all have stepped through that. And last but not least, Elder Finney for preaching and teaching and for breaking it all the way down. Your due diligence and your labor love has truly, truly blessed my house. And I want to thank y'all with all my heart. I thank you. And I want to thank Mother Bullock, too. She had a big impact on the women in my house. And I just can't thank y'all enough. These people around here are so tired of me hugging and kissing on them. I've been all home all week just hugging and hugging and kissing them. They just don't know. But they know now. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to the King.
Yep. Pastor, I want to thank you for so many warnings. I thank the Most High for so many warnings that he has given by way of Pastor Down. You know, I can go down a list and take up the whole broadcast, but one thing that really caught my attention was a while back when you warned us. You were just speaking about the world and the things that are going on in the world in the hour that we live in. And you talked about Syria. And I said, what is Pastor talking about? But I'm just going to wait and see, because everything's fine in Syria. And it wasn't long. It wasn't even a year. All hell broke loose.
All
the warnings that you've given us.
Hell broke loose.
Sir?
I said all hell broke loose.
Broke loose. The warnings that have come to you about the United States monetary system, the bankers, the politicians, the political system, the public schools, the Supreme Court. I remember when you talking about how militant the homosexuals are. And I'm thinking, how militant can it be to put nail polish on and act a damn sissy? You know, what is Pastor getting at? I so damn found out when you said militant, I mean militant. These people, this agenda, the movement of Satan and this agenda, all the warnings that you have given have all come to fruition. Now, I'm not trying to say that Pastor Dow is something that he is not. No, Pastor Dow is obedient to the Most High, and he's been blessed. He's been so blessed that the word says, Pastor, in Ecclesiastes, because it says, for in much wisdom is much grief. And he that increases knowledge increases sorrow. So I know that you think long and hard. I know you a little bit now, Pastor. I've been around a minute. I know you a little bit. I know you think long and hard. And you told us that you think long and hard and you go through before you give us information. And I'm appreciative of it. And I just want to thank you, Pastor.
Well, you know, I've been deceived before. And I don't like the way it felt when I came to the knowledge of the truth. And I made sure that I would support and defend the truth. And I made sure that I wasn't going to be lied to again. And neither are the saints of the Most High Yah. Not on my watch. Not those who listen to me. Anybody ever come over here, they're going to hear the uncompromising, unadulterated truth. And it's going to be the truth straight way.
Yes, sir. You know what, Pastor? You warn them too. You warn the world. Because a lot of people that listen to the YouTube, the weekly YouTube videos, they're not part of the ministry. But, you know, you put that out there for the world to also, you know, be educated and learn and not be ignorant of these things. And one of the things you warned them about was the 5013C.
True.
And with that being said, and you had talked about so many things that come along with that, that they had no clue what they were getting themselves into, but maybe some of them did. All I can say to them is that you said they was militant. You said how that tax deduction, that tax break, that marriage, that churches or whatever you want to call them of the world, when they file for that 501c and become a part of that system that is in place, they are going to bow down and they're going to serve that system. And with that being said, what the point I'm getting at is cream puffs, cupcake, and sugar pants gonna get their restroom built. Oh, they gonna build them. PBJ don't know it, but they about to have some construction up around their Potter's house.
Woo! I tell you what, a lot of parents got a lot of choices and decisions to make this upcoming school year, don't they?
Oh, Pastor. And you know what? When you look back, you warned us about all of this, and it all has just
come
laid
to pass.
Out exactly. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But you know what? You know what they could do? If we could put together a Hebrew Israelite construction crew, and we'd build a restroom for you, but they'd be like a roach motel. They check in, but they never check out.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
I tell you what, I'm so thankful that we took wisdom and received wisdom. And we've been homeschooling. Our last child, we pulled him up out of there. He's getting homeschooled. I ain't got to worry about none of that mess. And we are thankful for it. And just keep feeding his sheep, Pastor Dow. Keep feeding his sheep. We do thank you. We pray for you. We support you. And we serious.
Bro, Mike, I do appreciate it. I appreciate
yes,
all your letters, your offerings, your support, your prayers. I mean, I do. I love you dearly, my brother, the family, very dearly.
Yes, sir. Pastor, can you imagine how I feel? A house is totally in order. Everybody's in their role. We in harmony.
Oh, yeah. Harmony. You're feeling good.
Yes, sir. Pastor, hey, did you say Elder Rufus is preaching tomorrow?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can I say something else?
Go ahead, he's listening.
Bless you, Elder. You know I love you. I'm going to say it again. I'm going to say it again, Elder. Ecclesiastes 1, verse 18. For in much wisdom is much grief, and he that increases knowledge increases sorrow. Shabbat shalom, Elder. We love you. Bless you, Pastor.
Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Yeah. I mean, I don't mind giving all the wisdom and knowledge, but it is true. The more you learn, the more you know. You have wisdom. Sure do increase in a lot of pain. You sure do. Let's go to Iowa, Bro Charles. Call number 515-515. It's Pastor Dowell. You're on the service. You hear your broadcast. How can I help, Bro Charles? Bro Charles, you there?
All right, you know, brother, she didn't respect the wisdom that I was learning. And without, you know, I know at one point I learned the pastor story, you know, passing down or here's some good word we can consider God and talk to her about it. She'll be like, I'm worried about that, what you're saying. But then pastor story or passing down thing, and then she'll be like, okay. And I'm like, I just told you the day before they even said it. Like, I just told you this.
All right, Bro Charles, that's a bad connection. Glory to the King. Nebraska, Brother Eric, call number 308-308, Pastor Dowell, you're on the Straight Two Radio broadcast. I can help you there in Nebraska.
Hey, shalom, Pastor Dowell.
Shalom, 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 Brother Eric, shalom.
Hey, love you. I just want to tell you how much I love you and the saints, and that I'm excited for Shavuot coming upon us.
Hallelujah.
Hey, Pastor, I have a friend, a brother here that would like to talk to you. Would that be all right?
Sure.
All right, I'm going to put him on. Love you, Pastor.
Love you, my brother. Sure.
Shalom, my pastor.
Shalom.
This is Pastor Joe Fox.
Oh, I hear your voice now. How you doing, Pastor?
We're good. We got all the Straightway Kansas City Saints down here, plus others. Everybody say shalom.
Shalom!
Hey, shalom.
So we thought we'd call in and encourage you because you're encouraging us.
Glory to the King. Pastor, how you doing with your preparations of getting ready for that 200-mile Ozark Road March?
Hey, I'm working on it every day.
Really?
Alternating rucking and running, and then yesterday, instead of doing either, I mowed with a push mower about 2 miles of grass.
Oh, you are getting ready. How your feet doing?
Oh, yes, sir. Hey, you know, you carrying a rucksack, Pastor. We can't just pick it up and do it tomorrow if we're serious about it. We got to train for it.
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir. I don't know if I need to let this cat out of the bag or not, but you got any stockings with you?
Oh, not yet. I'll get to that. I used to wear like ladies' knee highs underneath my with the white fire. Yeah, you know the deal.
Yes, sir.
But I wouldn't buy them. I'm not that secure. I'd make Sister Kate go buy them.
You got that right. Y'all having a big time up there, ain't you?
Yes, sir. We got about 60 saints here today.
Woo! Glory to the King. That's all right, Pastor.
You still there?
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Yep, we got about 60 saints here, and we got a big weekend planned. And Pastor Corey's going to preach tomorrow. I'm doing what you do. I got a pastor here. I'm gonna sit in the front row and watch.
You got that right. That gives me a break.
Right. Then we're probably gonna do a mass deliverance tomorrow night, and then we'll have another service on Thursday.
Glory to the King. Well, y'all have a wonderful time, Pastor. I know you're gonna take care of the saints. Got two of you there. So that I know one thing. We ain't got nothing to worry about up there. Y'all got it covered.
Yes, sir. All right, well, I hope some prayers are with you, Pastor.
All right, love you. Hey, send Brother Travis and family I love and do, and the wife and the children up there, along with my beautiful sister Kate.
I will pass that all on, Pastor.
All right. Love you, Pastor. Shabbat shalom.
Love you, too.
Shalom, shalom, Pastor.
Shalom, Israel. Bless y'all. That's beautiful. Brother Eric is up at Shofar Mountain with Pastor Fox, along with Pastor Corey. They got like 60 people there. It's a beautiful thing. Glory to the King. Feast of Pentecost. I'm glad to see everybody's getting together. Let's go to Brother D. Jerry. Call number 786-786, Pastor Dow. You're on the Straightway 2 radio broadcast. I can have Brother D. Jerry.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor. Shabbat shalom, Yisrael.
Shabbat shalom. Bless you, Brother D. Jerry.
Pastor, I just wanted to call and give honor to the Most High. Give honor to the Most High, I'm just full of joy, Pastor. That's all. I'm just full of joy, Pastor. I'm so grateful and thankful to the Most High. He lives. He lives each and every single day of my life, Pastor. And if you can't give Him praise, that means you got a spirit you're working with. You know what I'm saying? I'm not speaking to you in general. I'm speaking about everybody.
Right.
The Most High deserves all the glory. He deserves all the honor.
Hallelujah. Glory to the King.
Hallelujah. I ain't got much thought that I'm just going to let it rip and enjoy the Shabbat. I'm ready for the Feast of Pentecost. I'm able to spend it here with my family, and I'm just filled with joy, Pastor. That's all I got.
Glory to the King. Let it rip, my brother.
Shabbat
shalom, Brother Jerry. Shabbat shalom. Glory to the King. Let's go to Virginia. Call number 571-571, Brother Chris. It's Pastor Dow. You on the Straightway Truth Radio broadcast. I can help Brother Chris.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor.
Shabbat shalom.
I just want to thank you for standing for Yah's truth and crying aloud and sparing not.
Well, you're welcome,
it's,
sir.
It's pray really inspirational.
Well, pray for me.
Yes, sir. Absolutely. That's kind of all I wanted to say. I did have a question, but I don't really want to ask it anymore. But I just want to say Shabbat Shalom and bless you, Pastor.
All right, my brother. Bless you. Shabbat Shalom, bro, Chris. Shabbat Shalom. Glory to the King. Let's go to Pennsylvania, Brother Zach. Call number 717. 717 is Pastor Dow. You on the Straightway Truth Radio broadcast. I can hear Brother Zach.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor. Shabbat shalom. How are you?
Hey, Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom. All right, my brother. How are you doing?
Oh, Pastor, I'm hanging in there. I just wanted to call in and give praise to the Most High. Thank Him for my blessings and trials and tribulations. And I want to thank Him for putting all the people He's put in my life these past year or so. I mean, I could take the time to go through and name everybody, but everybody knows who they are, and I'm just truly blessed to have friends and, well, family for that matter, that honestly care about me and about the other family members in my life, and I'm truly blessed to have them all in my life.
Glory to the King. Well, my brother's good to hear from you.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I've been. I was really happy tonight because I past couple weeks, I've been falling asleep, trying to stay up for the call, and I kept falling asleep. So I was really, it's really a wonderful blessing. It was really a wonderful blessing to be able to listen tonight and to call in. And thank you, Straightway, and all the saints for praying for my father. And I would ask that people still lift him up in prayer. He's still having a really tough time, but just keep the prayers coming, and I'll update people if we get any more news. So again, keep doing what you're doing, and all my friends and family in Straightway, love you all.
All right, my brother, bless you. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Glory to the King. Let's go to Texas. Caller number 972-972. Pastor Dow, Unisrebi Truth Radio Broadcast. How can I help you there in Texas?
Hey, Shabbat shalom, Pastor Dow.
Shabbat shalom.
How you doing?
I am all right. Who am I speaking with?
This is Brother Mitt down in McKinney, Texas.
Brother Mitt in McKinney, Texas. Man, I think I've been there before.
Yeah, Nick Lewis.
I think I've been there before.
Yeah, we're about 30 miles north of Dallas.
Yeah. How can I help you, my brother?
Just want to call in to you and say hello to your brother and make myself known to you. I never talked to you before, but I've been listening to you for a good while.
Glory to the King.
I want to say a shout out to everybody down in Kansas City. Pastor Corey, Brother LaRon, Brother Snow, Brother Miguel. Shabbat shalom to you fellas. I didn't want much in that, and I just want to make myself known and tell you Shabbat shalom. Hope you have a good day. Look forward to hearing from you tomorrow.
Hallelujah. Stay in touch, my brother. Shabbat shalom. King coming.
Shabbat shalom.
Hallelujah. Glory to the King. Last call for the night. Brother Cody, New York. Call number 716-716. This is Pastor Dow, Unisrebi Truth Radio Broadcast. How can I help you, Brother Cody?
Shabbat shalom, Pastor Dow. How you doing?
I'm blessed of the Most High God, highly favored, Brother Cody. Good to hear your voice.
Hallelujah. It's good to hear you too, Pastor. Yeah, I just wanted to call in. Just wanted to say I love you all. I'm doing very well. Hallelujah. And the Most High is good. The Most High is good. He has been blessing us so much. Hallelujah.
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 He has.
Yes, sir. I just wanted to say, Pastor, you know, when you were doing the message the other day, actually the past couple of Shabbats, and you've just been digging in so much into the ancient paths, it's just been beautiful.
I love
it so much. I love it. I love just the whole marriage that is supposed to be in Yisrael. I love it so much.
Glory to the King. It's a blessing. I love what the Father is doing. I love all the saints. I do. I love Israel. I truly love Israel. I love all the Israelites. And Yah is good to us.
Yes, sir. Yah is good. But yeah, I just wanted to say that. I love y'all, bless y'all, and also I got Brother Tyree right here with me. Shabbat shalom, Shepherd. Shabbat shalom.
Hallelujah, bless you, my brother. Glory to the King.
Glory to the King. Hey, bless you, Pastor. Thank you for your labor of love as well. I just got finished watching the last video too on firearms as well. I was just talking about that earlier today too, and as soon as I got in the house, I seen that video. I'm like, listen, look at this. It's just a beautiful thing. I wanted to share something. I want to share a testimony on. Me and Brother Cody just started some new job, both at the same time, same place, working, driving. Since we've been able to get back, we actually got work, and. The Most High is really blessing our hands, and it's a really beautiful, beautiful thing, because I didn't even expect to get the job at all. I wasn't even going for it. I was taking Brother Cody, and I ended up getting it and getting suspended and actually getting a test from the boss, and he was like, man, y'all are some great drivers. So, glory to the King. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. He, it was a beautiful thing, because I sat in the driveway. I wasn't going to do anything. I told him, go ahead, and he came back out like, yeah, but you got a CDL, and they want somebody with a CDL Class A. And I'm like, they want a lot of stuff on the application. I ain't got my stuff ready. He like, just come in and fill it out. I'm like, all right, we gonna do it. Fill it out real quick. End up getting the call back. Both of us at the same time. Beautiful. We end up taking a test with the boss and didn't even know it. We didn't even know that we were taking it with the boss, and we took it with the boss, and he came back and spread our name through the company like, I want these guys. We were just supposed to be on like a summer job. We ended up getting on a union, straight up on the union. We like, what? They straight changed our whole plan and everything. I'm like, okay. So it's been very beautiful. We work at a school district. We both drive, delivering school lunches, milks, and different things. Since I've been there, I actually seen the children. They're having to press a number when they get the food now, like that, like a PIN number. Oh, I actually watched. I was like, wow. Yes, they made the children was getting the food. As they got the food, they went up like it was an ATM machine and pressed the number and boop, 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 boop. I was like, wow, I'm so happy my children don't go to public school. Oh, man, I was just looking. I'm like, man. And then the guy told me today, he said, oh, yeah, this last school we go to, this is middle school. I'm talking about these children got to be about 8, 9, 10, each one of the schools we go to. He said, yeah, you go to this one, it's ratchet, it's ghetto. It's going to be some crap there. They probably get in a fight. As soon as I get there, little girl, oh man, pants on, you should see her hand all swinging around, don't you say this about me, get right into a fight. I said, dang, this guy just was talking about this, and I'm like, oh man, it's just, I heard y'all talking about school, and I wanted to share that testimony that they're actually making the children actually type in to receive their lunch. I don't know what else they're doing. This is our first week there, but Pastor is definitely a trip out here. Yes, it is. It is a trip.
I'm glad I'm away from it.
Hallelujah. Yes, sir. We definitely cannot. That's why we're getting together, to come out of her. I'm so happy. My children never touch foot in not even one public school. And I have 5 children. And when they hear that right here, they usually be like, you homeschool your children from there? Like, yeah. They never touch school. Not no these public schools. I just didn't want to have to deal with a lot of the arguing and fussing and different things that I had to go through when I was in public school. So, glory to the King. And, yes, we will be over. Brother Felix is tomorrow and the next the feast. Yes, sir. And I wanted to let the children speak because they had some testimonies, but they are a little bit asleep right now. It's 2 of them. But just say Shabbat Shalom to Pastor straightway. Come on, ready to go.
Shabbat Shalom, children.
Shabbat Shalom,
Pastor.
Shabbat
Shalom.
Hallelujah. Yes, sir. We don't want to take up all the time, but bless you, Pastor. It's a joy just speaking to you. And Shalom, Israel. Shabbat Shalom, Israel.
Shabbat Shalom.
Hallelujah.
I'm out. Woo! Bless y'all. I'm out. Uh-oh. Look at him looking.